Hey, it's Brad and welcome to the kitchen today. What I have for you today is an elixir that is going to knock your socks off. What is an elixir, you might ask? Well, you know what? We're gonna make our own tea blend and then we're gonna add to it some healthy, lots of goodness if you look around here. So we're gonna add some Brazil nuts to it. We are gonna add all sorts of chai spices to it. We got cinnamon, we got ginger, we got turmeric, we got peppercorns, we got some cardamom and some cloves. Those are all gonna go in there today. We have some raw cacao powder. We've got a little bit of Himalayan sea salt. We've got some coconut oil. We've got some raw unpasteurized honey here. That is all gonna go into it. But first we need to make our tea base. If you're like me, you know what, when these first came out, you might have gone to one of those commercial coffee shops and you ordered a chai latte and it tasted pretty good. And then you start to maybe investigate why it tasted good. And you start to see some of the ingredients and the listing and you come to realize that it is loaded with, well, things that really aren't that good for you. They get a ton of added sugar. And frankly, they don't have a lot of real spices in them. You're getting a lot of water, you're getting a lot of filler. And again, you're not getting a lot of the really good things. So we are gonna teach you today how to make one, your own tea base here. So all I'm doing right now is I'm chopping up some goji berries here and we're gonna put them in our pot here. We're gonna let them simmer away for 30 minutes. We are gonna add to it some cinnamon here. We're gonna add that into it. And again, it's gonna pull all of those nutrients right out of these goji berries, right out of that cinnamon and into that tea base. And then from that tea base, we're gonna add all of these other ingredients here. We're gonna pull the Vitamix out or whatever high-speed blender you've got. And we are going to chop away. And we are gonna, well, you'll see it as it starts to unfold. So all I'm doing here, I'm chopping up a half a cup of these goji berries here, rough chop. Again, sharp chef knife always makes life easier. Just watch your fingers, make sure that you are working with the knife and the equipment that you feel the most comfortable with here. These guys are a little bit sticky on the end of the knife there, so as you pull them off, just be careful for those fingers. Again, no injuries. We're gonna, again, make sure those all get a rough chop, open up that surface area. These goji berries, they are so good for you. They have so many antimicrobial, antifungal, anti-cancer, anti-inflammatory properties. It is just beyond goodness. So these are gonna go right into there. Being careful with that knife as you do it here. I know some of my chefs are gonna hate me for using my knife to help pick things up. You should probably use a bowl scraper. I got one of those here, I didn't grab it. So you can just grab all that. That way you don't dull your knife. We're gonna toss in 3 cinnamon sticks there. And to it, we're gonna add 4 cups of some filtered water. We're gonna let that go in here. We are going to turn on our device here. We're gonna let this simmer away. We're gonna go for 30 minutes. We're gonna take that, let that roll, like come to a little bit of a boil here. We're gonna let it simmer away 30 minutes. We are gonna put the lid on so all that heat stays in there and we will come back. All right, and we are back. It's been about 30 minutes or so and we've let our tea base cook away here. It has got so much sweetness, richness, deliciousness. Look at that, you can just see that. So what we're gonna do next, we are gonna take our tea base, we are gonna carefully, again, remember, we don't want any kitchen accidents. If you're lefty, pour whatever's more comfortable. If you're righty, pour whichever way is more comfortable. But we are gonna strain out all of that cinnamon, all that goji berry, and we are gonna be left with just a tea base. We've got lots of room now. So those discards there, they've done their job. Those are gonna disappear. And what we are left with is our beautiful, beautiful tea base. Step number 2 here, we are gonna take our tea base. It is gonna go into our Vitamix. You could measure this out there. We want about 3 to 4 cups. That's gonna go in there. Into our Vitamix, we are gonna add some Brazil nuts. Again, careful splashing here. We don't want to make sure that we don't get any accidents there. We are going to put our lid on. And if you have a high power blender, make sure when you're using it, look at where the vent holes are. So that way, whenever you're doing something that's hot in a blender like this, if it's closed and there's no room for it to breathe, the only way for it to go is straight up, and you will have a big mess and potentially hurt yourself. So you want to make sure that that's all set up there. One hand on the top, make sure it's steady. Again, make sure you're on low when you go to turn this on. So we're gonna slowly turn this guy on. We're slowly gonna increase. We are now have here is essentially a Brazil nut milk. Richness, nuttiness, deliciousness. Again, hot, so be careful here. We are going to take a fine mesh bag or nut milk bag. You can find these at most cooking stores now. And what we're going to do is we're going to pour our nut milk through there. Again, this is going to be super hot, so we got to be careful. If you want, you can let it cool down just a little bit so we don't burn ourselves. Those Brazil nuts are going to add minerals and vitamins and antioxidants and just such a creaminess to this drink that we're making here. So again, what you're left with here is, as we carefully, gently strain this out here, this is going to be hot, so we're probably going to leave this for a couple minutes because I don't want to burn myself, but what we'll be left with is our nut milk. We'll finish straining this off. We're gonna clean out our Vitamix, and then we're gonna add in the rest of our chai type spices. We're gonna re-blend it. All right, we're all set up here again. The blender's been cleaned out. What we're gonna do is we're gonna pour our Brazil nut milk back in here. It is still piping hot. It is delicious. All right, and now what we're gonna do here, we are gonna add in 3 tablespoons of raw cacao powder. We are going to add in all of our chai spices. So again, we've got peppercorns, we've got cloves, we've got ginger, we've got cinnamon, we've got some turmeric, and we've got a little bit of cardamom. That's all going in there. Again, if you like one spice more than the other, you can go ahead and add more or less of that. We are going to add in a little bit of coconut oil. Get that guy in there. Again, lots of healthy fats in there. We are going to add in some, one of my favorite ingredients. We have some raw honey here. It is antimicrobial, antibacterial. It is just, it's going to add such a richness and smoothness. And if you make a mess in your kitchen like I do, that is totally okay. It just happens. And we'll finish this off here with a pinch of some Himalayan sea salt, maybe 2 pinches. I like a little bit extra in there. We are going to make sure all that gets put in there. Again, high speed blender. It is hot. So let's make sure that it is vented properly. We want to make sure that no one gets burnt, no accidents happen. So again, making sure also it starts on low. We're going to turn the power on. We're going to increase that speed. We're going to take this cut all the way up. Fully blended here. We have a gorgeous nut milk chai latte. I know you might be thinking it's got a little bit of work. It's got a few steps in it. You know what? I know going to a drive-thru and just grabbing something might seem easier in the long run, but I guarantee you this is going to taste better. It's got way more nutrients into it. And frankly, when you're sitting around on a cool summer evening or into the winter and you're just looking for something that's going to be full of goodness, is going to make you warm and toasty and delicious right from the inside out, this is going to hit that spot. We'll give this a little taste. It is going to be hot, so I wish you could be here to taste this. Give it a little taste. Oh, you can taste the chocolate. You can taste the ginger, the cinnamon, the turmeric coming right through there. Not too hot or peppery from the ginger or the black peppers. It just gives a little bit of depth in there. This is 100% deliciousness.